What's up, everybody? All right, so today I want to show you my little grow out tank where I have all of my different cuttings and everything that's sort of just chilling in here and growing larger, so that when I put them out into the bog area that I'm working on, they'll be able to survive. But what I want to show you today is this, a Stylidium Debile, if I'm saying that right, or a frail trigger plant. Now, native to Australia, this plant is very quirky. You've probably seen a lot of videos on it that highlight the triggering aspect of the flower, which I try to get a picture of, and I'll try to put a video here in for you to see. It is very, very small, so these flowers will get much larger. Well, the stalks will get much larger. The flowers don't really. The stalks can get up to a foot tall or so, but the flowers stay relatively minuscule. And the reason why I want to highlight this plant today is I consider it a full carnivorous plant. However, the common theme is that this is what's called a proto-carnivore or a part-time carnivore or whatever you want to call it. The reason for that is the carnivory happens on the flowers. So the only time this plant is carnivorous is if the flowers are in bloom. And so I'll show you it later on in this video why that is. The back of the flower and the stem have little tiny hairs on with mucilage, much like a sundew, that is able to attract, capture, and digest prey. In my mind, that makes it carnivorous. The reason why it's considered proto-carnivorous is because it can only do that when in flower. But however, there are a lot of different instances of carnivorous plants that are only carnivorous at certain times of the year, but I'm not looking to stir up anything. I do want to highlight this plant. It is becoming wildly available in a lot of collections, and for good reason. It's an exceptionally easy growing, very fast growing plant, considered a weed if you don't want it to grow in a large collection. Now, if you know anything about my channel, I like growing everything in a very community sort of base way. I don't care about separations. Let me get some more light on here. I don't care about any of that. I like the feel of it being natural and growing all together. And so that is what I've got going on here. And so I've got this growing in here as well. As far as feeding it goes, I'll show you a little bit later in the video what I'm talking about, but I just spray some diluted Maxi on it, just like I would my sundews, and foliar feed it, and it does just fine. This thing absolutely is a monster as far as growth. Now I'm gonna try to get in a little closer and show you some pictures of what it looks like up close. All right, so if I can get it to focus here, I've got my giant hand down here, but the reason why I do this, I've got it on 3x focus. Now, these flowers are absolutely minuscule. This is a new Stylidium plant, so these flower stalks will be much taller, but these are probably the size of pepper grains, if you will, very small. But the reason why, let me see if I can get it closer, pardon the craziness of the camera. You see the little tiny, like little hairs that look like they're sticking off from the bud there, or the back of the flower there. That is the reason why these things are considered proto-carnivorous, is because those little sticky hairs there produce a small amount of mucilage that is able to attract, much like a sundew, attract and snare and then digest insects. And so it's considered proto-carnivorous because it only is carnivorous on the flowers, and so it is only carnivorous when the flowers are present. And so that right there is what you're seeing, is that carnivora. It is very much, again, like a sundew. I wish I could get closer, but that is the limitations of my camera, I do believe. There we go. Look at that. That's a good better shot. Sort of, maybe not, but you could barely see it on it. And I'm talking, these things are tiny. I've got my camera at 3x the zoom, and you could still barely see them. There's a little bit better shot, and so that is why they're considered carnivorous. Boy, I'm having a hard time saying that, aren't I? Right here are the flowers. Here's a closer look at those snapping mechanisms. So now, if I try to put my finger on the flower and show you the different parts, this camera is going to go crazy. But that little appendage, if you will, in the back is what holds the pollen. And when you when an insect comes along, a pollinator comes along and hits that middle of that flower, that little appendage will shoot forward and sort of bop the insect or the pollinator on the back, which puts the pollen on the pollinator.
As you can see there, there's some more of those little sticky parts underneath the flower as well. I think these things get a bad reputation for being a proto-carnivorous. I think they should be considered fully carnivorous, but I can see why not. But there are plenty of plants out there that are only carnivorous for certain parts of the year. But without stirring up too much controversy, this is Stylidium Debile. If I'm saying that right, Debile, I do recommend it for any growers. Super, super, super fast growing. This was just a small quarter-sized chunk probably about a month ago, and now it is spreading all throughout. Now you can see some growing out here. There are some pups there and a pup there and some over there. This is because this plant grows from its roots, and so it will spread out its roots underneath, whether it's in soil, whether you put it in a pot, it'll grow out from underneath the bottom, and it will spread its roots out and it will grow. Now, normally you would not want it in an enclosure like I have it in that's so large. Here, let me stop the video so I can get a better look.